This is a movie about Tommy Douglas.
I died! But!
Checkmate, my friend. No.
Somebody's been shot.
St. Joseph's goat. Lead the way. Oh, St. Lucas's beard. Oh, what a gruesome sight. Oh, dear God.
Are you all right, young one?
Leg.
Are you?
Leg.
Tell me what happened. Quickly, just tell me.
Well...
I died!
Aw, oh, damn, that's misfortunate, young one. Well, there's only one thing we can do in this case. Gonna have to do some surgery.
Wow.
Now, doesn't that feel better?
That was the best surgery ever!
Well, yeah. What can I say? I'm a miracle worker.
Well, I'll say.
Yeah.
So what's the bill?
Bill? Why, there's no bill.
What?
Cause it's pioneers like Tom and Douglas.
Push! Push!
Tommy Douglas was born October 20th, 1904 in Falkirk, Scotland.
Come on! Come on!
Hey guys, I'm Tommy Douglas. It's a good thing we got that covered under Medicare.
Oh, I'm a small boy and there's something wrong with my leg. Oh.
As a child, Douglas injured his leg and developed osteomyelitis. The leg would have been amputated were it not for a doctor who saw the condition as a good subject to teach his students.
You know, that looks like a good subject to teach my students with.
Oh, free Medicare, that's a great idea.
What?
Thanks to this doctor, Douglas's idea of free Medicare came into being. At age 15, Douglas started an amateur career in boxing.
Yes!
Perfect. In 1924, Douglas attended the Brandon College to study for the ministry. While he was there, he was asked to join the social gospel movement.
Hey, want to join a social gospel movement?
Sure.
He completed his master's degree in sociology from McMaster University in 1933. Following this, he became a minister at the Calvary Baptist Church in Weyburn, Saskatchewan.
All right, young one, go with Christ. St. Steve be with you. All right, no, exit that way. Young one, go with Christ. Power of Christ compels you. No, exit that way. Excellent. All right, next. All right, let's go. All right, Diane. Wait, I'm not. Go with Christ.
Douglas's main concern was Medicare.
My main concern is Medicare.
In the summer of 1962, Saskatchewan became the center of a hard-fought struggle between the provincial government, the North American medical establishment, and the province's physicians, who brought things to a halt with the doctor's strike.
The doctors went on strike.
After Douglas resigned from the position of Saskatchewan's premier, Diefenbaker took up his idea of free Medicare.
Medicare should be free for all.
Wow, what a great story.
Yeah, that Tommy Douglas, he's a great guy.
What?
Yeah, he's great.
What are you doing?
Can I go now?
wait, no, tell me, just, I'm afraid I'm gonna have to put you down, my friend.
Okay, so, we believe that Tommy Douglas belongs in the Natural Law School of Jurisprudence because he believes everyone has an equal importance when, in the eyes of their health, and that, you know, nobody should be more important or have any more degree of importance beyond them, and everyone should
be equal.
Thank you.
So Tommy Douglas, his Christian beliefs influenced him greatly in his creation of the free Medicare system.
Yeah, and his Christian beliefs, like the Christian doctrine basically is that everyone, you know, is equal in God's eyes, so why not be equal in human eyes as well? So,
Napoleon Bellecourt belonged to the Natural Law School of Law. Napoleon Bellecourt belonged to the positive Natural Law.
I got that.
I'm a fish game
with this guy.
Everybody stutters one way or the other, so check out my message to you. As a matter of fact, I don't let nothing hold you back. If the scat man can do it, so can you. Everybody's saying that the scat man stutters, but does and never stutter when he sings. But what you don't know, I'm gonna tell you right now that the stutter and the scat is the same thing. Yo, I'm the scat man. Where's the scat man?